So someone can ask that what is the proof of this claim, as we know that majority of us are not happy because they don't have enough money, they don't have good job, they don't have good business, and they don't have money to buy happiness in form of material things. So someone can say that we are not happy because we don't have the material things. So how you can say that we are not happy because of lack of zikrullah? So I will explain. And now take the examples of Awliya Allah. We know that throughout the Islamic history, there were some most pious people in Islam. So the few moments of this player can never give us long-term happiness, well-being, and inner peace. Ladies and gentlemen, dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wassalatu wassalamu ala hatamin nabiyyin, amma ba'd, fa'audhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. We know that in modern world, majority of us are not happy with our lives. We are not happy with our relationships, we are not happy with our jobs, we are not happy with our incomes, we are not satisfied with our lives. So this unhappiness and lack of satisfaction leads us towards mental health issues. But we don't realize that Islam has provided us all the solutions of our problems. In Surah Ra'd, verse number 28, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَّا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Those who believe and whose hearts find comfort in the remembrance of Allah, surely in the remembrance of Allah do hearts find comfort. So dear brothers and sisters, according to this verse of Holy Quran, the satisfaction and comfort and inner peace can only be attained by zikrullah, by zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our this body belongs to this world, and the needs of this body can only be fulfilled from this world. Just like the things we need, just like the things we want to eat, all these things comes from this world. But the spirit or the soul or the ruh, that belongs to heart. So dear brothers and sisters, the heart is the house of soul, and the soul or ruh or spirit, that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the happiness or food or anything that our soul required, that can only be achieved through zikrullah, so through zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Isra, verse number 85, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا. And they ask you about the spirit. Say, the spirit is of the command of my Lord. So just like the source of our body is this world, and food and the needs of our this body come from this world. Similarly, the food or inner peace or happiness or joy for our soul can only be acquired through zikrullah, through zikr of Allah, through ibadah. So just like the source of our body is in this world, and to feed our body, we require the things that are available in this world. Similarly, the source of our ruh, our spirit, our soul, that source is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we want to get happiness and we want to get inner peace, we must keep ourselves busy in the zikrullah, in the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in ibadah. So dear brothers and sisters, even if we can't understand the relationship between soul and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, still we can know that to feed our soul, we have to do zikrullah. We have to keep ourselves busy in zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we are not happy in this worldly life, it's not because we don't have the things or the money or materialistic things. Instead, the reason is this, that we are not connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we are not busy in zikrullah. So someone can ask that what is the proof of this claim? As we know that majority of us are not happy because they don't have enough money, they don't have good job, they don't have good business, and they don't have money to buy happiness in form of material things. So someone can say that we are not happy because we don't have the material things. So how you can say that we are not happy because of lack of zikrullah? So I will explain this, that we know that there are a lot of people in our world who have all the things they need, who have all the material things. They have enough money, they have good business, but still they are not happy with their lives. They are not satisfied. They don't have inner peace. Why? Because these things, these materialistic things, cannot fulfill your inner needs. Your heart, your soul, that demands something else. Because the heart or your soul that is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even having a lot of material things, money, etc., majority of these people are not happy, and some of them suffering from the mental health issues. They are depressed, they are anxious, and they don't know why don't they have inner peace. Just because these material things can only give you the happiness for a little moment, and they cannot fulfill the needs of your heart and soul. And now take the examples of Awliya Allah. We know that throughout the Islamic history, there were some most pious people in Islam. And even in this current world, these kind of people exist. And they never complain for their life. They never complain for material things or money. They never try to increase their assets of this world. Instead, they always try to keep themselves busy in zikrullah, in zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in ibadah. And still, without having these material things or enough money, they are happy and satisfied with their lives. They have real inner peace. The kind of inner peace we can just imagine. Why? Because they always keep themselves busy in zikrullah and in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So dear brothers and sisters, Allah bi zikrillahi tatma'innul qulub. We must realize that we can only find inner peace, well-being and happiness in zikrullah, in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So stop finding peace in the material things of this world. Your heart will never fill with, and your addiction of getting more and more will keep you busy until your death, but you will never find satisfaction. Narrated by Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if Adam's son had a valley full of gold, he would like to have two valleys. For nothing fills his mouth except dust of grave, and Allah forgive him who repents to him. So the pleasure and joy of material things only remains for few moments. And after that, our heart will demand for more and more, and this addiction will never end until our death. So the few moments of this pleasure can never give us long-term happiness, well-being and inner peace. Now we must know about the difference between desire of luxury and the needs of our daily life. So keep yourself to acquire the needs of your life, and do not busy yourself for getting luxury life or for fulfilling your desire. Because desires of material things will lead you to a wrong path. Because the desires will never let you find inner peace. So try to keep yourself busy for only minimum things you require for your daily life, and work only for your needs and not for your desires. And while working for your needs, keep yourself busy in zikrullah and in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now there is another dimension of the explanation or commentary or tafsir of this verse of Holy Quran. According to the Tafsir Dar-e Manshur and Tibyanul Quran, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated that when this verse was revealed, the Holy Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, these are those people who love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and my Ahl-e Bayt, and they love to all Muslims who are present or absent. Listen, they love to each other due to Zikrullah. In this hadith, the Ahle Bayt means the family members of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is the another beautiful dimension of this verse of Holy Quran, that we should love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we should love to Holy Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we should love to the family of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we should love to the companions of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we should love to all Muslims who are absent or who are present. So this is a beautiful message, and when we will love all of them, all the Muslims, definitely we will find inner peace, and this will improve our mental health. In my coming videos, I will try to keep making videos related to Zikrullah, inshallah azza wa jal. And thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.